All right, so I did a little alpha release from last time, and so I haven't received any feedback from it. So actually, I think that shows two things, and the first one is that, well, the value for this new functionality isn't very big. And I think there's actually more value in the performance improvements that this will have, that gain will actually influence everybody, not only the ones that need the suite or the list of the suites functionality. The new functionality, and also the fact that I actually fixed the argument file box has a big impact. But yeah, bugs are so that people usually don't give feedback from them for things working. They can give feedback for things not working. Yeah, that is the value that I think this exercise will give based on this little alpha release. One thing also is that because no feedback was given, I think currently this is mostly working. So there's no very, very big bugs in this release. Yeah. But there are some things that I need to still change before making an actual release, and one of these is the hash of directories currently goes through all the files, not only the files that the Robot Framework is actually interested in. And one big thing is that I need to limit the files that I'm getting, well, calculated for their hash code, so that I don't go through things that might be like gigabytes of stuff that is irrelevant. So yeah. So for that reason, this needs to be changed. And that is the part that I still need to fix. But after that, I think there might be an actual release. And then later on, I will make another video about how the release did go. But let's continue from this little card. Oh yeah, and then there's another to-do, which is that the hash codes actually change a bit in Travis. So that I need to also fix, and to fix me here. Travis hash codes are different. So this I need to also somehow fix. Let's start from here. So robot actually has many different file types, extensions. So let's see if I go through here so I get all the extensions from here. And I think there's actually a way to get those extensions out of Robot Framework. let's go for first through the help. No. Okay, this is really new. So the idea here was that only that the system should only parse those files with, this is basically the same stuff that I'm doing. So it's an optimization so that you would only use one of the extensions instead of parsing through everything. So go to robot framework and see if I see if there is easy way to see these extensions. Do I have access to the hash code? Let's see. And then maybe I'll just grab four extensions. Robot parsing text extensions. Test extension. What is this? Letters readers. Oh yeah. So parsing purple letters. So there's the readers list, but I'm so inside of the robot that this is not public API, so I cannot use this list. So unfortunately, have to for now do it here. So robot extensions. Basically it's a set of list of these extensions that robot uses. So And what we need to do with this extension is doing the hash is here. We need to check what we get from the file. Split. Split. Final component of that name, this name, go to the back to the robot and see how this get size is. There is for his link split. I can also add a dot. Maybe I'll do that. Just add a dot. So, and then for the hash code, where was it? And for int, any. Any actually, but it does. So if I have some list of things like false, this will return false, and if there's one true, it will return true. Same with p and rob. Extensions. So then I will have that there. So let's see. Now I have some caution back. Don't. Oh, and switch. Currently my tests don't actually test this, so I need to add some file that is ignored. TMP. Should not go here in situation. So Now the data source is actually changed. What is that? Doesn't take that as part of the file. The files are insorted order. This changes. It actually goes there and updates the hash file. With the name of the file. This needs to work differently. So if it's file and one of the ones here actually interested in that case we should do this. In all the other cases I don't think we need to even think about the directories. This should be actually here. Yeah, so now it works. Uncertain why I did this now in the way that I've done it before. This I need to check. Well, I think now we have a correct way of using this. So we're only interested in the files. Trying to figure out if there was some real idea in this. This version. It comes from here. Buggy hash code. So at that point I had problems that didn't consider file names. File name changes couldn't affect it. And the order was a bit random, so should contain the file names. Now it should be in the correct order. For some reason, I did this on this part. Now it's inside here, so assume that it's now correct. Yeah. Consider this done for now. OSWalk might be also keeping a different order in different cases. let's see how it goes. I think that is it for now. I need to check out the Travis code also later on, but for that I need the internet. So this is this recording now, and there's my little changes. So I just fixed the hash code so that it should now work in a way that it only considers the files that the robot framework is also interested about. And also I think the real value in this exercise comes from the performance improvement and the fact that I'm fixing also the argument file box, not so much about the possibility to change the execution order of files. So that's it for now.